The Pap Attack.
You know, Rick Santelli's an unlikely character to be complaining about taxes and deficits. But it knocks on the door of ridiculous when you recognize that he was an organizer of the not-so-spectacular teabagger protest. The head teabagger, Santelli, never protested when George Bush handed about $150 billion to AIG and $30 billion to Bear Stearns. We never heard a word out of the head teabagger when his Wall Street cronies were bailed out with taxpayer money. But Santelli showed indignant outrage when President Obama began spending money on Americans who were actually losing their homes to foreclosure at a rate of about $50,000 a week. That Santelli teabagger crowd was outraged when Obama created a stimulus package to put the average American back to work after 8 years of failed Republican policy. But I gotta tell you, I have some great news for the Santelli teabagging crowd, but it's probably not what their Wall Street pals are gonna wanna hear. You see, the public interest research group PIRG, well, they found billions of dollars hidden in offshore corporate tax havens. Now, this no doubt's gonna upset the teabaggers to know that there's more than $100 billion worth of tax shelters offshore created by many of Santelli's Wall Street pals. We don't have money to pay for schools or teachers or roads or healthcare, but billions of dollars are sitting in no-ask, no-pay corporate tax shelters right offshore. Go online and look at PIRG's data, and you're gonna see that those protesters in Florida who took the time to dress up in those ridiculous patriot costumes and hang tea bags all over their body could have found billions of dollars worth of unpaid revenue in corporate tax havens, just right offshore. In fact, last year, Florida taxpayers lost $5 billion in the offshore tax shell game. Now, on the other end of the country, if you were one of those California teabaggers dressed up like Paul Revere or Martha Washington, you probably would have felt overwhelmingly stupid once you learned that $11 billion in revenues left that state to places like the Grand Cayman Islands. You know, I'm not actually sure most of the teabaggers were actually focused as much on taxes as they were on letting us know that they were still angry that their political party was trounced in the 2008 elections. But what seems hard for them to accept, almost impossible for them to accept, is that they lost because they began to look too creepy. Between Sarah Palin, Joe the Plumber, Rush Limbaugh, and now Bobby Jindal, the weight of weird has been holding the party down for years. And that was even before Santelli and his Wall Street crowd dressed the entire damn party up like peculiar Minutemen and convinced them to hang Lipton tea bags from all of their body parts. It's not just intuition that tells you that this party is completely, utterly out of touch. The polls show that a solid majority of Americans approve of Obama's plan to salvage our economy after 8 years of torturous GOP policy. Obama last week announced that he's committed to shutting down tax loopholes like the offshore corporate tax scams identified by PIRG. Obama seems to recognize that as we close down schools and healthcare services, as well as police and fire departments, we begin to look more like a banana republic. You see, Obama wants to end the cycle where the average American sacrifices more so Santelli's corporate pals can sacrifice less. Now, to me, that sounds like something we ought to be partying about.
The Pap Attack on Air America Radio Network.